Hello everyone, Firecrest Gaming here, and welcome back to another video. We're back with MotoGP 17, and we're continuing with the managerial career mode. I went ahead and done some more of the rider career mode, and it's much less interesting than this. So, let's go, in a second, because I found out a few more things. I bought one of the staff management, I bought one of the departments in the pits, which was a track engineer, and track engineers supervise everything regarding to the bike's performance and lap time and interface with the rider to better understand their needs. Expand this department to reduce research and development time for your bike frame. Not 100% what that does, but what I'm going to do is go into the race. And I'm going to turn up the AI to hard mode, even though this bike is very much not that good. If you remember, we got the wild card right at the end of the last season. I can't remember if we had a bike or not. I think we had our own bike back then, and we ended up getting qualifying on pole, and then we went back to last straight away and then went back up again. So this time, let's modify the bike a little bit on corners, handling, change the response up, and then get speed up. Et voila. Yes, we definitely had our own bike. 10th down in the first sector. It's to be expected. This isn't the fastest bike by any stretch of the margin. Oh, that's too deep. Bring it back. Right, just give it to me. How bad is it? 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Is it going to be... Oh, we're 14th. Okay, I'm going to go again because I reckon I can do better. Maybe this is going to be a bit better. We're fastest in that first sector. That's more what I like to see. I think it's these two corners that really mess it up. I don't know which corner it is, but there's a corner somewhere in this middle sector that really messes me up. Maybe it's this one? I don't know. All I know is these two around my tail, and I'd rather they didn't interrupt my quali lap. We are still 14th at the moment, so it's looking alright, I guess. Gonna guess it's orange. 0.4 down almost. Oh god, I'm over the curve. You didn't see anything. Come on. No, please don't. I think that's Mia or Martin. I believe it's Mia. It is, and he's ruining my lap. What an absolute beep. God damn you, Jorge Mia. Or however you say your goddamn name, I don't know, and I don't care. Get out of my way. Oh, if I can get him ahead of me in the final corner, then I can use him as a tow. This lap is not over. Mia, please overtake me. Please overtake me. Please overtake me. Please overtake me in this last corner. Normally the AI aren't that good in this corner. I've gone out wide, though. Surely tow. Yes. Thank you, Mia. Oh, this might actually be quick. Come on. Thank you, Mia. That's the last one for me. Oh no! 2 minute 12.2. Half a second. I'm happy with that. If we're inside the top 10 in quali, then that's something. Because I reckon in the race, we might be able to do it. I think we can do this. 10th place in the end. Behind Antonelli and Bastianini, ahead of Migno and Oetti, our teammate is in 32nd. Terrible showing from Alexis Taylor. Hopefully you can learn from this and get better. Because I have a feeling that he's going to be finishing in the bottom half of the table for quite a while. So it's Mir, Canet, Martin, Fenati, Breviga and Di Giantonio, McPhee, Bastianini, Antonelli, ourselves, Migno and Oeti, Rodrigo, Noridin, Loy, Guevara, Danilo and Cornfowl, Sasaki, Dalla Porta, Suzuki, Ramirez, Arbolino and Binder, Herrera, Arenas, Bezecchi, Baglini, somebody else, Toba, Taylor and Pulkkinen. This is it. It's game on. Four lights. Lights out. Here we go. I can never get a good start in this game. How do you start well in this game? I lost two positions already to, I think it's Migno and Noetti. We'll have a look up the inside into turn one, maybe. We'll get Oeti back. No chance on Migno. But he's going to maybe push Romano Fenati out. How did he end up so far down? And I'm going to have a look at the inside, maybe Antonelli. Bit of contact there. And Bastianini's going down the inside. And we have Anina. And we are on the back of Di Giantonio. We're going to try and overtake him. Maybe for fifth place, we'll stay on the back of him. And we'll maybe have a look where we're losing the time. But right now, if I can stay with Di Giantonio, that'll be quite something, because we are currently in sixth place, and we're maybe looking for fifth, because Di Giantonio is looking very slow there on that corner. But he went slowly in, fast out. We're going to try and hold on the exit on the power into fifth place. Okay. This is good. This is very good so far. But Di Giantonio sends one up the inside. We're going to go side by side, I believe, with the Italian. He's got us on the inside. No, we had a bit of a wobble. He almost had us, but we're diving it back up the inside. And Di Giantonio swapping positions left, right, and centre with the. No idea what bike it is. Oh, that's Fenati now. Making a recovery ride, and he's up to sixth place now. And Bastianini is also getting past Di Giantonio. There goes Fenati. Clean pass. That was very quick pass. And Bastianini as well. And this is getting ridiculous. I just lost three positions in one corner. Right, let's have a look back at the inside. Maybe Bastianini, not quite. We can line up move, though, onto the main pit straight. Migno is fighting with Antonelli. And Bastianini is having a look up the inside of Romano Fenati. And power out of the corner, come on. We've got a good ride onto there, so we just need to try and follow Fenati, I think. We'll try and get his toe. And it's no use. That bike is so fast in a straight. And here comes Migno, I think. Yes, it is. It's Migno. And Antonelli's come flying through as well. We've had to go on the wide line. And it's no use. They're going through. We are sinking like a stone here. We've got them back. Next up, it's Fenati. And he's trying to force Bastianini wide there. We're going to have a look maybe at the inside of Anina, Bastianini. We've got the move done. And how about Fenati? Maybe just send one up. Oh, contact. We've just made that stick with a lot of contact, but regardless, we're through. Fifth place. Who's next? It's time to find a bit of a groove here in Qatar. We've got Aaron Canet ahead, so I think he's going to be a bit out of reach in this Grand Prix. But we're going to focus on keeping Romano Fenati at bay. And we've got Bastianini and Antonelli fighting behind as well. This is absolute chaos. And now we've got Fenati at the inside and Bastianini again, same corner. They both just fly one up the inside. Bastianini! We've got stuck on him! Nope, not having that. Not having that at all. That's not on. Why did I just get stuck to him? There we go, up the inside of Anina. Whoa, contact with Antonelli there. He's trying to force us out wide. Our teammate in the rider career mode. really not showing us any courtesy here. We're going to try and keep it clean, but I think Fenati may be completely gone by this point, unless this last corner provides us with some help. He just flies in there and he doesn't break to the apex. What are these AI? They are weird, to be honest. They just have this ridiculous amount of pace, but I don't understand where they get it. And here comes Nicolò Antonelli. Thanks for the push. We've got Bastianini up inside. And Antonelli and Migno, I think. Oh no, it's Oetti now. And then Migno's behind us. Along with Antonelli, we're going to dive one up the inside of Nia Bastianini. We are still somehow holding on to sixth place. We are being very aggressive. But still, we are holding on with everything we've got. And Fenati isn't exactly running away. He's got a gap, but it's not that big. But we are more just focusing on keeping this position, staying ahead of Bastianini and those kind of people. I know Bastianini's dropped down to 9th. I'm not sure who's behind us then. It might be Oetti. Well, we might be about to find out very soon as we go very wide there. Number 65. Yeah, it's Oetti as he dives one around the outside there. Very nice move almost by Oetti. And then he cuts back to the inside along with Migno, and there's Bastianini. We're having a look now around the outside of Migno. And up the inside of Oetti, maybe, not quite. I think Oetti might be another one to say bye-bye to. Maybe here. No. I tried on my weakest corner. I tried to dive him. Although we are staying with Oetti. And then we go back at the inside. Got him. Back up to P6 now. Can we maybe just one more time and try and catch Fenati? This is the last time I'm going to say it, and then if we can't do it this time, then it's game. Then Fenati's off. Oh, jeez, that's off. We're closer to Fenati than we've ever been. We might be picking up just a bit of a toe. Please, come on, Mahindra. Half a second ahead. It's possible. It is entirely possible to catch and overtake Romano Fenati. But I just need a little bit. I just need a little bit of pace. Fast lap I can at 2:11.0. That's faster than quali. Oh, here comes Fenati. Oh, we've got maybe. We're really closing up to Romano Fenati now. We're really. Maybe going to have a look of making a move. I'll tell you what, Mir and Martin are getting a bit close for comfort. Oh my god, we're actually in a position to overtake. We're actually in a position where we've gone up the inside and we've completely messed it up and we're going to let Fenati back through. Oh, that was it and we messed it up. Right, keep it clean. Keep Fenati in your sights. This isn't over. I've given it everything, but I don't think it's going to be possible. I think now this is the sector where the AI flourish. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. He's slow. I'm just saying this is the sector where the AI flourish. Fenati has just opened a door for us. Got to get a good run through there. That's very quick through there. Get a good run through here. Come on! No! No, 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 no! Right, final two corners, this is it. We are actually close. We have a chance in hell. We have a chance in hell. I mean this, we actually have a chance in hell. Fenati's gonna go slow on the apex here. Oh my god, this is it! We've got a good exit! Come on! We're going to drag race it to the line. We're gaining. I'll be that last second magical fifth place. Yes! Eat your heart out, Romano. Oh, well, Blaker lost by 0.03 of a second, and between us and Fenati, it was 0.06 of a second. Oh, man, 2 minute 11.1, so we did actually have... We actually set the exact same fastest lap as Blaker. And where did our teammate finish in the end? 32nd. We do need to do some work on this bike. Fifth in the championship, obviously, as race standings go. That's how it is in the championship. Then we enter ourselves in third place with 11 points. KTM second on 20, and Honda lead the way with 25. Oh, man. To say I am on the edge after that is an understatement. That was so freaking close. Oh. Yeah, it looks like we're happy. Oh, man. Yes. Race. Okay, starting position 10th, final position 5th, race objective was 20th, championship position 5th. Okay. Ooh, okay, so he does start to grow his stats, I guess. Oh, I believe we just got some money, so we can upgrade this bike. Because seriously, I need the upgrades, if I can buy them. Oh, I can buy something. Bike development, Mahindra. Oh, what was the biggest problem with us? I'd say it was the power, but that isn't true. We were also having problems in the corners, and we can get a double upgrade. But speed and acceleration is too... I say two upgrades are better than one. Oh no! Oh, we can only upgrade one part at a time? Oh! Damn! Hot damn! Oh, God, we're gonna have to struggle through. Oh, great. We're gonna have to struggle through Argentina, I guess. Oh boy!